I'm Valder Beebe, host of The Valder Beebe Show. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview. Interviews with today's pop icons, movie stars, and celebrities. Tune into our FM radio broadcast and our online broadcast. Visit ValderBeebeShow.com and SoundCloud.com/ValderBeebeShow. I'll see you there.
Alexa Bonto here in Dallas, Texas, to talk about a really important subject on the Valder Beebe Show. I'm so honored that you're here.
Thank you so much for having me.
Well, I was reading the promo material. We're going to talk about your health or your wealth, managing the cost of diabetes. I never thought about the cost of the disease, and I'm sure many people haven't. So let's talk about it.
Absolutely. Let's dive in.
Okay, cost. It costs more than maybe other diseases, or is it just a high-cost disease?
So, Valder, what we are finding is that medical costs with diabetes are about 2 times for people with non-diabetes. And what that really equates to over 5 years is about a 41% increase in your costs. And as you can imagine, that takes a real toll on your wallet.
I'm sure it does. So, when someone is diagnosed with diabetes, hold on to your wallet as well as your wellness.
That's exactly right. And recently I've teamed up with Roche Diabetes Care. They did a survey around the United States of 500 adults aged 26 to 64 and found some pretty important facts that we wanted to properly share. So the first is 58% of people with diabetes are actually cutting corners on their health treatment because of the burden it really puts on their wallet. And 75% of adults with diabetes are really straying from their diet. Which both of those things are not great given the fact that your health really is your biggest asset.
Your health is your wealth tool, as I tell people every day.
Exactly.
Okay, so the survey results gave us these nuances of the disease and what it's doing. What about those financial barriers? How is that frustrating people?
So what we're finding again, and you know, our tips to really help people combat this is a few things. One, most people in America are stressed out about their wallet. About 74% of the country lives paycheck to paycheck. But rolling up your sleeves, getting involved with your wallet is so important. And as your friendly financial planner, I always tell people that not having a financial plan is a plan. It's just a really bad plan. So sit down, do things like come up with a budget, track your spending, really think comprehensively about where you want your financial life to be. Second, for those people with diabetes out there, we want to make sure that you remember that there's this great card. It's called the AccuCheck Guide Simple Pay Program. This brings really good predictability and transparency to buying your test strips, which as a financial planner, I like anything that gives you control and consistency. And again, it allows you to really focus on getting those strips reliably and at a transparent price. And then finally, we want to think about best ways for your wallet for you to eat and stay healthy.
All right. So getting sick is not cheap is what you're saying, according to what you saw in the survey.
That's exactly right, Valder.
Why is it taking us so long to make the connection between our wallet and our illnesses?
I mean, I think just in general for people, most people struggle with their wallet. And then on top of that, if you're struggling with your health, it's a lot. And so here are the sort of things I think everybody should do. First, if you're interested in learning more, head to AccuCheck.com. That's AccuCheck.com. I provided a ton of personal finance content that can help you connect those dots between your health and your wealth. Just as you said, I always say that no matter what, every day that you live, both of them are going to matter. So we want to make sure that you take care of both. And then finally, for people out there with diabetes, just remember that what you eat matters so much. And so my favorite tip for managing that part of your life, financially speaking, is just two quick things. One, remember every time you go into a grocery store to actually shop the perimeter. That's where you have your healthiest food and also your least expensive food. And then my second tip is just basics of things like packing your lunch and planning out your meals can go so far. Even saving $5 a day, if you add that up across a year, put that into your retirement account, you're going to be in a much better spot financially. And so a little goes a long way.
Alexa Von Tobel, you are going to be my favorite person because you have done your homework, you've done your research, and you come well qualified. Alexa is the CEO and the founder of LearnVest.com, and head on over to that website and get some information. Thank you for being my guest today, Alexa.
Thank you so much, Valder.